Good evening. My name is Dr. Catherine Caronia, and I am the designated institutional officer and senior vice president of academic affairs and chief academic officer for Catholic Health Services of Long Island. Welcome to our 26th graduation ceremony, certainly a very different celebration than what we would have anticipated coming into this academic year, and certainly different than we could have ever imagined when you joined us for orientation at the beginning of your training here at Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center. However, nonetheless, just as monumental an achievement and one that we would like to celebrate and acknowledge for each of you and your families. Our program will begin with a few words from our local and system leadership, but first, we will begin with a prayer from the Most Reverend Bishop John Barris from the Diocese of Rockville Center.
I'd like to congratulate our Catholic Health Services medical education graduates and your families. I am so grateful for the sacrifices you have made to serve Jesus Christ and the mission of mercy of our Holy Catholic Church expressed in Catholic health care. I'm also so grateful too for the way you've embraced the power and mystery of the cross of Jesus Christ in these COVID-19 times of trauma and death. I'm so very grateful to you, and now I pray for you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we ask your blessings upon your Catholic Health Services medical education graduates, their families, and all their colleagues. We ask that the Holy Spirit may lead you and guide you. May the tongues of flame give you great strength and fortitude, give you great conviction in your vocation to serve the church and all of humanity. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you all.
Thank you, Bishop Barris, for the beautiful blessing. Today, you take a big step in accepting power known only to an elite group. With your white coat and your diplomas, NPI numbers, medical licenses, DEA numbers, stethoscope, and knowledge acquired over the last 2 to 4 years, you enter today a life of new and vast privilege. You may not have noticed your power or have recognized it over the last few years, and you may not have felt powerful or privileged. Certainly not when you were filling out endless billing forms and swallowing crazy rules and requirements, struggling through hard days of too many tasks. But know this, in return for your years of learning and your dedication to a life of service, and your willingness to take an oath to that duty, society will give you access and rights that it gives to no one else. Society will allow you to hear secrets from frightened human beings that are too scared to tell anyone else. Society permits you to use drugs and instruments that can do great harm, as well as great good, and that in the hands of others would be weapons. Society will give you special titles and space of privilege. Society will let you build walls and write rules. Throughout your lives, you as physicians will meet people and families at their happiest moments and at their saddest. You will meet them every day, every hour. They will be in disguise. They will be in disguise as a new mother afraid to touch her preemie on the ventilator. As the construction worker too embarrassed to admit that he didn't hear a word you just said after it might be cancer. As the alcoholic bottoming out who was the handsome champion of his soccer team and dreamed of being an architect someday. Or perhaps disguised as the child over whom you tower, or the 90-year-old grandmother over whom you tower. Disguised as the man who would prefer to know and he who prefers not to know. Or disguised as the man who wants you to call him Bill and the man who prefers to be called Mr. Smith. The rules of medicine are not in the hands of the nameless power, not the people who make the rules, the policies, the governmental officials, the accrediting bodies. It is in your hands. What is at stake here may seem a small thing in the face of the enormous healthcare world that you have just joined, the ever-changing healthcare systems. The cost may seem like a nickel to the $2.6 trillion industry, but is what really matters. It is all that matters. It is the person, the individual, the patient, the poet, the writer, the adventurer, the frightened soul, the wandering mind, the learned mind, the husband, the wife, the son, the daughter. That is who matters in the moment. And in the moment, it is all about choice. You have a magical opportunity. You have the opportunity to decide. You make the choice. You can read the rule book, and someday even write the rule book. Decide. Yes, you can hide behind protocols and policies. Yes, you can say we when you mean I. Yes, you can lock the door. Say sorry, your 30 minutes are up. You decide, because you can also unlock that door. You can ask, shall I call you Bill or Mr. Smith? Would you like to be alone with your family now? Is there something else that I can do for you? Decide. You can read the rules, the book on how to complete a full history and physical, perform the complex surgical intervention, treat the 60-year-old construction worker with back pain, resuscitate the infant brought in cold and blue, or how to treat the alcoholic with DTs. Or you could say, pardon me. Pardon this unwelcome interruption in your lives. Thank you for inviting me to help. Thank you for trusting me to be a part of your life. Now, what else can I do for you? Be the ongoing change that the medical community needs. It is not all about medications, surgical techniques, and the latest and greatest in tools of the trade. It is the human interaction and the dignity that each of you can bestow upon those who seek your help. This is what individuals, families, patients remember, and we all play a part. We are so proud of the physicians you have all become. Maintain the humanistic qualities that brought you into medicine to begin with. Only you can decide. It is your choice. You are our future, healthcare's future. What I have witnessed in each and every one of you throughout your training, and most recently through the COVID-19 pandemic of 2020, affirms that healthcare is in good hands with you at the helm, actually in great hands, and you should all be very proud of what you have accomplished, the care that you provided and the sensitivity and compassion that you exhibited. You have all acted incredibly as skilled physicians, professionals, and individuals. Good Samaritan Hospital thanks you. Congratulations to each of you, and God bless you and your families always. Now it is my honor to introduce Dr. Alan Gersey, President and CEO of Catholic Health Services of Long Island.
Thank you, Kathy. I want to congratulate all of you for what you've accomplished in recent years. I know how hard you've worked. I haven't forgotten my own residency. And you should all be very proud of what you've accomplished. If you're married, I want to thank your families for their forbearance in putting up with your work schedule. I want to make two comments today. The first is that I hope your completion of residency marks the beginning of a lifetime of learning. In the 1960s, the dean of the Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine used to address the incoming first-year medical students with the following statement: half of what we teach you over the next 4 years will be proven wrong in the course of your careers. Now, it's not quite that bad anymore, but it's still probably 10 or 20%, not to mention all the unimaginable things that you will learn in the course of your careers that are not known today. So please read your journals, attend rounds, go to professional meetings. Not only are these things intellectually stimulating, these will ensure that you are able to provide high quality care. And last but not least, a very wise person once said, no one cares how much you know until they know how much you care. So please keep that in mind. Thank you for your service to Good Samaritan Hospital. I wish you the best of luck in your careers. And now let me introduce Ruth Hennessy, the President and Chief Administrative Officer of Good Samaritan Hospital.
Thank you, Dr. Gersey. I would like to wish a special congratulations to our 2020 graduates from all of us here at Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center. Like many people across the country, these last several months have been unlike anything any of us have ever experienced. But unlike many others your age, you didn't spend that time home from school or working remotely. You were here, right in the midst of the greatest health crisis of our generation. Simply calling you essential would be an understatement of what you've accomplished. And you didn't just live through it, you rose to the occasion. When there was need, you answered the call with a resounding response. Regardless of your areas of expertise and years of experience, you were there for us when we needed you the most. And for that, I will forever be grateful to this graduating class. I'm sure there are things that you have seen and experienced over the past several months that will stick with you for the rest of your careers. However, in that same vein, I hope that every time you hear Here Comes the Sun, or any Beatles song for that matter, that you can take a moment and be proud of the fact that you were part of the team that helped to treat and discharge more than 1,200 COVID patients. So now, as you prepare for a new stage in your career and a new set of challenges, take comfort in knowing that you can do anything. You've already battled and survived a global pandemic, but there will be times when you're not sure if you can take on the world. And on those days, I would ask that you think back and remember all of your friends and family here at Good Sam, because we will never forget you and what you've done for our medical center. Thank you and good luck. Now I'm pleased to introduce Catholic Health Services Executive Vice President and Chief Clinical Officer, Dr. Patrick O'Shaughnessy.
Thank you, Ruth. And thank you for this incredible opportunity to be part of this magnificent event. And congratulations to the Good Samaritan graduating class of 2020. While the events of COVID-19 have us socially distanced, it remains so important to take time to recognize and celebrate your collective tremendous set of achievements. First and foremost, special thanks to your loved ones who supported you throughout your residency to get you all to this point. I know I would not be where I am today as well if it were not for the sacrifices and support my family provided to me. And what a wonderful program. You were all blessed to be accepted into here at Good Samaritan. Let's take a moment to thank your Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Kathy Caronia, and all the incredible faculty and clinical staff that educated and supported you all during your residency training. Now, colleagues, and I can call you colleagues, I would not come to such an event as this without a gift. No, I did not bring a check and a card, but I do have something to offer all of you that I will hope you will value, and that is advice. Now, I'm not Tony Roberts, but I feel I can offer you some pointers that can help you along on your careers. First, some clinical advice. And likely even more important following that is advice about life in general. You see, it feels like yesterday I was sitting where you are, and this year marks my 18th year since graduating emergency medicine residency training. Yes, it goes that fast. So let me share some pearls in the hope that some of this sticks in those beautiful minds upon leaving Good Samaritan and starting your careers. Number one, embrace team-based care. Dr. Atul Gawande, a national leader in quality and safety and writer, wrote a famous article in the New Yorker a few years back regarding the need for more team-based care. We need less cowgirls and cowboys and more pit crews. More team-based care. Less of me and more of we. So I challenge you all, watch an indie pit crew. Watch aircraft carrier flight deck operations. Watch a well-organized code being run in an ED. When performed correctly in this fashion, it is seamless, effective, almost musical, like a symphony. You will serve your future patients well if you work in collaborative teams, each person bringing some degree of expertise to the table, but the synergy and overall output of the team is nonlinear and magnified beyond any one person's capabilities. Number two, embrace the humanity of your profession. Never lose sight of what it is you all are doing. That patient is not just an interesting case. You're caring for someone's grandpa, wife, aunt, son. I will stress for you all, healthcare is called healthcare for a reason. Many times in your careers, you may question what you're doing. For me as an ER physician, I used to always ask, is this really an emergency? Does this patient really need to see me right now? Remember, you're treating a human being, the human condition, the human person, the whole being. Don't lose sight of that. Many times you may be that last person of hope and they are there seeking your help. Let me share a brief story about what I really learned in emergency medicine residency training. Always look beyond the chief complaint. Number three, second guessing your chosen profession. Let me reassure you all that you have invested wisely in pursuing a career in medicine, and especially for choosing to train with us here at Good Samaritan. Population and population growth has grown tremendously over the past decade, and certainly over the past 100 years. 83 million growth annually at a rate of 1.1%. Global population has grown from 1 billion in 1800 to 7.6 billion in 2018. And predictive models say we're going to surpass 11.2 billion by this year, 2020. Population growth rate continues to increase between 23 and 25%. And newly and growing aged people with chronic diseases continue to grow as well. 39 million people were 65 years or older. And by 2030, there'll be 72 million seniors, amounting to nearly 20% of the population. And guess what? They will all need healthcare services, services that you will provide as physicians. To maintain current levels of care, which are largely not ideal, as we all know, primary care levels must increase by over 60%. Healthy Planet 2020 predicts over a 50,000 shortage of PCPs by this year, 2020. What's my point? Despite what you're all reading about with the challenges of the U.S. healthcare field, you all chose wisely and have chosen career paths that will be gratifying, fulfilling, and needed for many, many years to come. Remember the quote, "If it were easy, everyone would be a doctor." This is the best job in the world, despite everything, because of everything. Last piece of clinical advice. Healthcare operates in a VUCA environment. What does that mean? It means you have to innovate, adapt, and overcome. Benjamin Franklin was quoted as saying, "If you fail to plan, then plan to fail." I learned this well from my colleagues at the U.S. Army War College and even some time spent with the U.S. Navy recently. What is a VUCA environment and how do we succeed in an environment like this? Well, V is volatility. Expect the unexpected. Prepare for unexpected, and high reliability science can help you adapt to that environment. U, uncertainty. Change can happen fast. Be prepared for it. Always have a plan B, a plan C, and a plan D. C, complexity. Healthcare is complex. It's high risk and tightly coupled. Teamwork, as I mentioned before, and support. When all known limitations are exceeded, ask for help. Work together. A, ambiguity. Sometimes no precedents exist, which we call the unknown unknowns, right? So again, multiple contingency planning, and remember this, patients do not always read the textbooks. If nothing else, COVID-19 has reminded us all of this quite painfully. Now the life advice. You're all type A overachievers, I get it. Yes, that helped you get where you are now. But remember, the race never ends. So be mindful to balance life and career work, especially now as you start your careers as attending physicians post-residency training. Many of us, myself included, have passed on recreational fun, time with friends or family to support work and career growth. But don't keep pushing these things off for tomorrow. For as it has been quoted, if you pile up enough tomorrows, you'll find you're left with nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. Work-life balance and prioritization is critical for long-term happiness and fulfillment. Prioritize all you have to do, and remember what Jim Collins said in Good to Great. If you have more than three priorities, you don't have any. The key is time management, so learn to prioritize, and it's okay to say no sometimes to things that don't align in your immediate priority index. Wherever you are, make sure you are truly there. Shut down distractions, focus on the moment, and enjoy that moment. Cell phones, tablets, there's a constant barrage of information, much of which can wait, some of which is actually meaningless. Weed that out. Save time for creativity and imagination. Albert Einstein was quoted as saying, imagination is more important than knowledge, for knowledge is limited to all that we know and understand, while imagination embraces the entire world and all there will ever be to know and understand. So save time for being creative and imagining. Think it's silly? Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Elon Musk all hold time away from all distractions to simply focus on creativity and what could be rather than there is already. In conclusion, embrace and reflect back on all that you've learned in the past and be ready to build upon that platform and embrace your journeys to become our next generation of physicians, our future healers. Continue to learn, and while amassing great knowledge and advancing your careers are important, I implore you to embrace these pearls I have shared with you today. Don't be a cowgirl or a cowboy. Work in collaborative teams. Embrace humanity and truly care for your patients. Don't second-guess your career. Commit to it, but be fearless in the pursuit of what sets your soul on fire. Learn how to not only survive, but thrive in a VUCA healthcare space. Balance work with life. Prioritize, and it's okay to say no. Be truly present wherever you are and eliminate distractions and manage your time effectively. Continue to learn, but save time to imagine as well, and then imagine the future, and then help create it. You know, the Blue Angels' motto is, the sky is not the limit. So watch your thoughts, for they become words. Watch your words, for they become actions. Watch your actions, for they become habits. Watch your habits, for they become character. And watch your character, for it will become your destiny. Thank you again, and congratulations to the entire graduating Good Samaritan Residency Class of 2020.
It is my great pleasure to introduce Drs. Anthony Smapino and John Vullo to the podium to present the Obstetrics and Gynecology Class of 2020. Drs. Smapino and Vullo came to Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center after having completed their own residency training in obstetrics and gynecology as colleagues and as friends. Together, they developed the Obstetrics and Gynecology Residency Training Program here in 1998. Since that time, the Obstetrics and Gynecology Training Program is shown as an example of quality, maintaining a high bar for training and lifelong education for its graduates. A quality program, however, is not attributed solely to its leadership, but encompasses all who take part in education, including the dedicated faculty, departmental leadership, and of course, the amazing trainees in the program. So without further remarks, I would ask Drs. Smapino and Vullo to present their graduates of 2020.
Good evening, welcome to our virtual graduation ceremony. I would like to thank all of you for tuning in to listen to our virtual graduation. First thing I would like to do is congratulate all the graduates and all the programs. I would also like to congratulate our OBGYN graduates from our residency program. We have four graduates. They did a phenomenal job. They are excellent surgeons and they're great people. So I thank their families for that, because I believe that, and we believe, John and I both believe, that we have to have really good people to make great attendings. And your families have given us really good people, and you guys are fantastic attendings, and you're going to do great in the future. You led by example during this very difficult situation with COVID-19. By leading by example, all your junior residents have followed, and they've done a fantastic job throughout the last few months and with you guys for the last 4 years. So I congratulate all four of you guys. You did a great job. Dr. Vullo and I are very happy to announce all our graduates. We're going to take them one at a time. The first graduate that I'm going to announce is Hanalore Griffiths. I am so happy that Hannah came all the way from Washington State to grace us with her wonderful presence. From day one, she worked very hard, always with a positive attitude and a smile on her face. It was clear that she had a strong desire to be a great OBGYN physician. I believe one of Hannah's strengths is rooted in her significant family bond and upbringing. Hannah now has two beautiful children, Her second baby was born during her chief year. She handled her pregnancy very well, never missing a step, coming back from maternity leave without regressing at all. Hannah's a great bedside manner, good solid practice patterns, and excellent surgical skills. When asked by her future employer for me to be honest in my recommendation, it was very easy. I told them that there is no question of her character, professionalism, and ability to be a fantastic OBGYN attending. I also stated that if she were not so close to her family, that I would have pressured her to stay here in New York with us. Furthermore, I told them that they'd better be good to her because my door is always open for her to come back. Hannah will be joining Northwest OBGYN Clinic in Portland, Oregon. I think that she will be very successful and find time to get back into her OMM, her tennis, and her very wonderful karaoke singing. Congratulations on a great 4 years. We wish you much success and happiness in your future.
My name is Hanalore Griffiths. I just wanted to say thank you so much for this beautiful experience I've had here in New York. I feel like I was welcomed with open arms and treated like family here. I learned so much, and I feel like I grew as a clinician and as an obstetrician and gynecologist, and I just wanted to say thank you so much for the experience.
The next resident that I would like to call up is Lisa Shanahan. I remember back to the interview season in 2015. I did not get a chance to interview Lisa, but she really impressed Dr. Vullo and Dr. Trivedi. In reviewing her application, it was easy to see how she was on our A-list from the very start. Very good grades, 4 years working for the CDC, awards earned in medical school, research, et cetera, et cetera. It was clear that we were going to get a serious, dedicated resident that would take a leadership role. She quickly took on the challenge and responsibility. She is very well structured and organized. She led as a chief resident by example, always trying to be as fair as possible. She continued to push her junior residents to strive to do well on the CREOGS and also involve them in as much research as possible. She consistently showed her knowledge by scoring the highest in her class every year on the in-service exam. Both myself and Dr. Vullo are graduates from New York University. This is where we started our friendship of more than 30 years. Learning that Lisa would be staying and working at NYU in New York City has made us very proud. We hope that you will make a great impression on that very prestigious institution. Congratulations on a job very well done.
I'm Lisa Shanahan, and I am incredibly excited to be graduating and starting the new part of my career. I'm also incredibly thankful for the opportunity that I got to be here at Good Samaritan Hospital. I remember when I interviewed that I knew when I did my second look that this program was incredible and had everything that could ever be offered to somebody who could be with the dream of becoming an OBGYN. So I'm incredibly thankful that I got this opportunity, and I know that wherever I go, I will be able to bring great surgical skills, a knowledge base, great clinical medicine, but also have gotten to learn how it is to be an excellent clinician with patients and good bedside manner. I'm very much looking forward to share everything that I've learned from Good Sam everywhere, starting with NYU, and I'm incredibly thankful.
The next resident I would like to introduce is Amber Ward. What can I say about Amber? I recently looked back into Amber's application to our program. Things that stood out. From Canada, lives in Minnesota. Really nice girl. How would she fare in New York? Board score is very okay, but both myself and Dr. Trivedi ranked her at an A-, and then after conferring with Dr. Vullo in the future, moved it to the A-list. I was so impressed with our ability to see such great potential in her. It has been a tough 4 years for Amber. She has had some struggles, but determination, hard work, and passion to mentor and support her junior residents has impressed all who have worked with her. I have been in medical education for many years, and I must say I have not seen such an enormous amount of growth in professionalism, patient care management, and surgical technique in the fourth year of residency. She has received many compliments from nurses, attendings, and her peers. Amber has signed a very impressive contract and will be working in an OBGYN practice for Essentia Health in Duluth, Minnesota. Amber, we are so very proud of you and wish you success and happiness in your future. Congratulations.
I just wanted to say thank you to Dr. Vullo and Dr. Smapino for the very kind words. As they alluded to, this residency has been somewhat of a struggle, as I'm sure many of you could imagine. But I think the hardest part of it was being away from my family and friends. But coming here, the nurses, the staff, my co-residents have become a new family. And without them, I wouldn't have been able to get through this. And it's something that I'm always going to cherish in the future. So thank you for that. And I'm very excited to be moving back to Minnesota, back to my home.
The last but not the least resident to be introduced tonight is Naji Wajid. Let's see. Well, we got a female from Washington State, another from Minnesota, and another from Georgia. What's this? A male from New York, grew up in Syracuse, went to Cornell, and then the Osteopathic Medical School in New York. Finally, a high quality XY. Naji is so much more. From day one, he is led by example. You would never have known that a close family member underwent surgery during his first year of training. He is calm, respectful, and very even keeled. He has the ability to take each person's needs, desires, strengths, and weaknesses into consideration. He truly cares about each one of his residents and wants them all to succeed in reaching their full potential. Being a chief resident in an OBGYN program when you are the only male is not easy, even from an outsider's perspective. Being on the inside, he has handled his chief year with class, likely better than any chief resident that I have seen to this date. He has earned the highest respect from the nurses and attending physicians as well. He has a wonderful bedside manner, very good patient care management, and excellent surgical skills. Naji will be joining an OBGYN practice in Montefiore Nyack Hospital in Nyack, New York. They will soon learn how lucky they are to have him. I am very happy that he will be relatively close by, and the next time we are together, I will be happy to create a new mocktail for you. We wish you all the best of luck in your future. Congratulations.
My name is Naji Abdul-Wajid, and I'm very excited to be completing my residency here at Good Samaritan Hospital. I'd like to thank my wife and my family for their unending support over the incredible journey the last 4 years have been, as well as Dr. Smapino and Dr. Vullo and countless other mentors here at Good Samaritan Hospital that have helped shape me into the physician I want to be. I know I will keep everything I've learned here for the rest of my professional career.
The 2020 Paul S. Mandela Special Achievement Award is an award that we have decided to present to a special resident who is nominated by their peers. Just to give a little background on who Paul S. Mandela was, he was a physician here who began his career as a pediatrician, working with families who lived within the Good Samaritan Hospital community. He committed his professional career to pediatrics and the growth and development of services at Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center, while holding leadership positions that included chairman of pediatrics, as well as president of Good Samaritan's medical staff. In 1994, Dr. Mandela partnered with New York College of Osteopathic Medicine to develop graduate medical education training programs at Good Samaritan. He remained as chairman of graduate medical education until his retirement in June 2000. He was instrumental in the vision and development of many of the programs that we continue to have today. The Paul S. Mandela Special Achievement Award was dedicated in 2002 to honor the professional visionary he was and to recognize House staff members who, throughout their training period, have excelled in their dedication to and advancement of medicine. We are very proud of all of the residents who train within our residency programs and are dedicated to learning and providing quality patient care. This award recognizes the resident who peers, mentors, and core faculty have identified as someone who has exceeded in their commitment to education, professionalism, colleagues, and quality medical care above and beyond what is expected of someone in training. Through the nomination that we received from residents and faculty members, we identified one resident who we strongly believe stands out in their commitment to medicine, learning, and their community. This resident was nominated by the colleagues with whom they train. And this is what they said. Achievement is commonly seen as one distinct occurrence. It is, we are told, the one genius move or one great success that stands out. However, I think this is short-sighted. Achievement is slow. Achievement is patient, constant growth over many years. Achievement is changing how a group of residents see themselves and each other as physicians in training over a period of time. Real achievement, the kind that takes years to accomplish, is hard, and that is why I would like to nominate my co-chief, classmate, and friend for the Dr. Paul Mandela Special Achievement Award. Years of residency alongside this resident have taught me the wisdom of the mantra, remember why you are here. Each of us has a bit of a different answer. While we all dream of becoming physicians in our chosen field, that path is still unique for all of us. Beyond liking and respecting everyone, this individual sees each of us for what we dream of becoming and values our uniqueness. Nurses and attendings find this person to be a calm, collected, and a dependable member of the team because he has worked to gain trust from all members of patient care. Residents trust him to mediate differences and troubleshoot different difficult issues. Over the years, we observed many ways people can lead a residency program. His years-long commitment to create a culture of transparency in the residency leadership allowed for trust and honesty between residents to develop. He has only seen his chief position as one of service and a means to ensure everyone experiences progress. We remember why we are here because he never lets us forget why we came to Good Sam in the first place. He has been the best representative of what the program has to offer, professionalism, academics, and to find joy in one's work. When the COVID pandemic first started, we had to change our entire schedule. Then we changed it again the next week, and the week after that, and the week after that. The service still needed full 24/7 coverage. The clinic needed appropriate staffing. Sick residents needed to be off the schedule. And later, the residents all took their turn to cover medicine. In the face of all this uncertainty, this individual scheduled himself to work when he could have been on vacation. He wanted to ensure all changes were made smoothly and put the benefit of the group ahead of his own. From the beginning of intern year, he has always considered his commitment to Good Samaritan an important part of his resident role. When in his personal life, he had an emergency that required his attention, he continued to work his shifts, always committed to his role as an OBGYN resident. It has never been uncommon over the years to find him staying late or coming in early to help when we were stretched thin. This individual has represented Good Samaritan Hospital on a national level by presenting research to the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology annual meetings in both 2019 and 20. However, the biggest contribution he has made during his chief year is his overwhelming inclusivity of junior residents. He encouraged and took with him any resident available to his major GYN surgery cases, which in the past had been seen as signifying a more senior status. He chose to elevate his junior residents and increase their exposure and experience. He wanted to focus on those junior to him, teaching them and passing on knowledge with every opportunity. He is adept at giving junior residents a sense of autonomy and making decisions so they too can develop confidence once they become senior residents. Residents believe, as we do, that this resident truly embodies Dr. Mandela's commitment to a culture in residency, of seeing residents as servants, and of all of us that we are in Good Sam for one purpose, to fulfill our dreams. I am pleased to present the award to Dr. Naji Wajid, and I'd ask his residents to come up. Naji, this is to you, and this is from your fellow residents. And I didn't change very much. I just took his name out of what was sent to us, but you guys did a beautiful job. So, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm not sure what to say. Hearing all the words that my co-residents were so kind to write about me. It strikes me at the end of 4 years that we've really accomplished something incredible here. And I've always felt that working every day here has been a privilege to be mentored by such incredible attendings and be able to pass on that knowledge and skill to our colleagues that at the end of 4 years is truly something incredible. I'm incredibly delighted at receiving this, and I will cherish this, and it is very humbling above all. And I hope that myself and the rest of my colleagues are able to achieve everything we set out to.
Congratulations. The American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists has an annual mentor award that provides to anybody who's nominated by a junior fellow, which are residents in training or junior attendings, that they find that mentor has significantly changed their overall professional life. It's an award that's provided throughout the country to each district, and at times it can be more than one recipient per district. And my co-chief and I felt very motivated this year to nominate two individuals that we felt significantly stood out in our training over the past 4 years and significantly in the last year of our chief residency.
It's my privilege to introduce the award to our first recipient, and I will read the nomination that was accepted by ACOG this year. Dr. John Vullo is not just a mentor for residents, he's a fountain of wisdom for aspiring physicians in training since 1997. Every conversation goes beyond the basic medical plan. He connects with us on a deeply personal level, even in the face of insecurity, fear, and frustration. His reassuring demeanor is a source of constant encouragement. Dr. Vullo has an unmatched understanding of his residents and the tremendous challenges on the road to becoming practicing OBGYNs. His own training shaped the vision he would later bring to his over 80 residents, a premier OBGYN education in a community hospital on Long Island's South Shore. The residency program at Good Samaritan has grown since then, and Dr. Vullo has always made an effort to give guidance and direction to each resident. Advice on handling scheduling? Vullo. Complex consults that you're not sure how to approach? Vullo. Sending half the residency to present at ACOG? Better check in with Vullo. Graduating and need trustworthy eyes to look at your first contract? It's Dr. Vullo. To be sought out in times of joy and in doubt is a true measure of value. His interest in the person beyond the white coat cannot be overstated. Dr. Vullo keeps a big picture in mind under the mantra, remember why you're in residency. He's a true advocate for his residents, their journeys, and all the growth along the way. Dr. Vullo's mentorship never ends with graduation. It only follows us in the pursuit of our dreams. Dr. Vullo. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Totally unexpected, and I'm honored. Thank you. Thank you, all of you.
And now I'd like to present the second ACOG Mentor Award. One word defines Dr. Mark Pilateri's residence: hustle. You have to be quick, thorough, and absolutely right. His expectations are high, and the confidence of years of residency is quickly shed under his close questioning. You will be placed in a challenging environment every time. Dr. Pilateri suspends your role as a resident physician in training and treats you as an equal. You are his partner in managing complicated GYN surgeries in a high-risk obstetrics population. You are the primary surgeon while he helps you refine your approach, enhances your skills, and builds your confidence. Dr. Pilateri's residents gain an education that cannot be taught outside of this total immersion. The operating room becomes the arena for surgical perfection. The theater is filled with the sounds of Yo-Yo Ma. His instruction is deliberate because of his care and consideration for the individual resident he is across from. Dr. Pilateri does this while maintaining the largest OBGYN practice at our hospital as a solo provider. His contribution to our residency is seen in his role as a staff attending for our community-based clinic and hospital. He has touched the lives of over 80 residents over the period of 20 years. When Dr. Pilateri tells me I'm capable, I trust him. He knows me as an obstetrician, a gynecologist, a surgeon, and clinician. But more importantly, he knows me as a person with my own ambitions and dreams and provides me with the attention and encouragement to reach them. With Dr. Pilateri, we'd like to present you with the ACOG Mentor Award.
Thank you.
So deserving.
Thank you very much. I don't think words can put this to how I feel. Thank you.
I'm speaking directly to the OBGYN residents at Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center, and I want to thank you guys for coming down. Residency training is not easy. It's a difficult time. It's a tiring time. It's a time that you'll remember forever, and the colleagues and the people that you have worked with, lived with, and just shared everything with over the years that you've been here, whether it's 1, 2, 3, or 4 years, can become very difficult. It's not easy to be a leader in a program. Program directors, the associate program directors, work very, very hard in every day, just making sure that everything is in place to provide the best training for all of the residents within that training period or within that year. 2020 was an extremely difficult year. We saw a pandemic, a national disaster, an international disaster, and health crisis like we had never seen before, at least in the lifetime of most of us practicing medicine and most of us still alive to remember pandemics. So the pandemic or COVID-19 coronavirus does not define our graduates today. It does not define who our residents are and will not define you, but forever it will be a part of who you are. It will have a small piece. It will hold a small chapter in the book of your lives as what you went through, just like other experiences during your residency training and as you move forward in the profession. During this pandemic, we were under siege. It was a war, and all of you participated in as frontline providers for this war. Good Samaritan Hospital could not have done this without the dedication, the professionalism, and the work of all of our residents. You and the Department of OBGYN were pulled from areas where perhaps you felt more comfortable in, dealing with the female patient, gynecology, obstetrics, and suddenly you were tossed into areas taking care of patients with COVID. And yet you stepped in, you stepped up, and you gave it your 110% at all times. And I want to thank you for that. It's very easy to lead on a normal day. Yeah, it's a little difficult, but it's more easy. It's easier for us. But during the pandemic, we really worried. We were really concerned. And you guys really were that force to go out and work with us side by side to kill this beast. And we hope that we will not see a resurgence. And what we have done is what we have done. But I wanted to recognize, and this is certainly something, a certificate of appreciation for the entire OBGYN residency. And the certificate of appreciation is an appreciation of your heroic efforts and teamwork in support of Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center and the patients served during the COVID-19 pandemic of 2020. We would like to recognize the obstetrics and gynecology residents. Your devotion and commitment to serving the community will never be forgotten. You answered the call as an essential first responder and never wavered. On behalf of the leadership at Good Samaritan Hospital Medical Center and the patients we serve, we thank you for all that you have done. June 2020. It's signed by myself and Ruth Hennessy, the president of Good Samaritan Hospital. We hope that you will take this and forever perhaps put it in your new call room, where this will document and be dedicated to you and the services that you provided during this extreme period of time. So I want to thank all of the OBGYN residents. You really were an amazing group of physicians who stepped up and really provided what was needed for the community. Thank you.
Our training programs could not be what they are today without the incredible support and dedication of our faculty within each of our clinical departments. Each year, the trainees themselves recognize individuals who have made a difference to them as educators, mentors, and professionals throughout their training. There are so many people, mentors, physicians, educators, that have touched their lives, and with their dedication and commitment to the residents and the residency training programs, have truly made a difference. To all our faculty, please know that each and every one of you have truly made a difference. Tonight, our chief residents will be presenting the award for the 2020 Attending of the Year in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology.
This academic year has taken us through tremendous challenges, and more recently, uncertainty. We have seen hospitals strained by a growing patient load and resources stretched thin. But at the same time, we have seen how embracing uncertainty with confidence and efficiency could help us grow as physicians. Today, we want to recognize an attending who guided us to do just that.
This attending has worked immensely towards our education during a time of massive disruption. He has continued to stimulate our passion for the field. As residents, our concerns were met with reassurance, and we were able to learn and grow in an atmosphere of safety and respect.
Our attending of the year also emphasized the value of life outside of work. A huge effort was taken to check on each and every resident's well-being. We learned firsthand that to achieve our goals as physicians, we need to achieve our best physical, mental, and emotional health.
The last year of residency is a culmination of academic growth, advanced training, and lifelong connections. We felt that the attending of the year is the individual who helped us on every step of the journey. This year, for attending of the year, we would like to recognize our very own program director, Dr. Anthony Smapino.
So I'm a little shocked because years ago, I didn't think we were going to pick a program director or the chairman of the program. That was with our previous chairman. So I never expected to get an attending of the year award. It was very, very nice of you guys to do that. And I do truly appreciate it. But I'm your program director, and I love you guys no matter what. And I always do the best for you guys every day. So I don't expect an award. I really do appreciate it. It's very nice of you. That's all I can really say. I'm actually shocked. For once, I can't really talk. I can talk off the cuff all the time, but much appreciation to you guys. You guys are a great group of residents, and I think you're going to do fantastic in your future. And I'm very, very proud of each and every one of you. Make sure you stay in touch with me. I want pictures. I want texts. And I want you guys to meet me at conferences so we can go out and have a good time. Wow. So that's very important to me. So thank you very much, not only to you four guys, but also to the rest of the residents as well. So I do very appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I've been doing graduations at Good Samaritan since the start of medical education in 1995. Although I remember all of my graduates, I can't say that I remember all the graduations. I can honestly say that I will never forget the graduation for 2020. What a year. And through it all, our residents have stepped up and handled it as well as anyone. We always send the graduates away telling them to make us proud. This year, they have already done that. Here are some memories for our graduates, put together by our other residents. All of the lights.
Hi, Hannah, Lisa, Naji, and Amber. This is always really hard for me because you guys are like my kids, so it's bittersweet to say goodbye. We've watched you grow up, and we're so very proud of you. Know where you're anchored, and always know that you have a special place in my heart. In my heart, you'll always find a home. I will miss you so much. Please keep in touch. I love you all. Bye.
Three.
Hello, this year I cannot say the web and be as rowdy and all the noise for you guys. I just want to say Lisa, Naji, Hannah, and Amber, I love you guys. I wish you the best. I'm going to hate that my memories are not going to come and I won't be able to show you graduation. Love you guys and wish you always the best.
Same. We miss you all. You guys were great to work with. We'll wish you the best going forward and hopefully you guys come back and see us soon.
Love you guys.
Bye.
Naji, baby boy.
To Lisa, yay.
To Hannah.
To Amber.
Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations.
You make us proud.
Yeah.
So cute.
Good luck in whatever you do.
Come back and visit us.
We're going to miss you tons. Mwah, mwah.
Yeah.
Chaka-waka.
Good luck.
All right.
We'll be back. Yes. They know more than you do.
Love you guys.
Love you guys.
Perfect.
Hey guys, congratulations on graduating. Good luck being attendings. You guys are all gonna do amazing. Come back and visit. Bye.
Congratulations, fourth years. We're so happy you're graduating. Sorry to see you go, but good luck in everything you do. I know you guys will all shine in wherever you are. And keep in touch and keep delivering those babies. Congratulations.
Congratulations, guys. I'm sorry you guys didn't get like a crazy graduation. I hope this helps. You guys are awesome. We're gonna miss you so much. You better come back and visit. We love you.
Congratulations!
Hi, Dr. Ward, Dr. Wajid, Dr. Shanahan, and Dr. Griffiths. We are so excited that you're graduating this year. Congratulations, congratulations. This is your oyster. The world is your oyster. Good luck to you. Everything that you do is going to be wonderful. We're going to miss you. I'm going to miss you. I wish you all could be my gynecologist. Good luck to you. Love you all.
Thank you guys for everything you guys do for the community, for the HRH community. It's a pleasure for me to work with you guys. Congratulations. Thank you so much for everything. To be so good for us. Thank you. We're going to miss you so much.
Yay! Hello, everyone. I just want to congratulate all of you, Dr. Lisa, Dr. Shanahan, Dr. Amber, Dr. Hannah, and not to forget, Dr. Naji. I wish you the best of luck. Congratulations on your graduation. Finally, all this hard work paid off. Best of luck to you all. Take care. Bye.
Dr. Ward, Dr. Wajid, Dr. Shanahan, and Dr. Griffiths, congratulations on your achievement. It's been a pleasure to work with you all. Wishing you all the success on achieving more milestones in your lives. You'll be missed.
My life, and it's not easy when you guys are gone and I don't see you anymore. And I am very happy to see you back again.
Wait, can we record you now?
Oh my God.
I'm recording her.
Oh, you are?
Oh my God. I know. My goodness. This is so, it's sad, but at the same time, I'm so happy because it's 4 years. It's like I learned every single one day. Attitude, the behavior, the acting, how they're laughing, how they are, you know, and I'm trying to be, you know, the way they are, and I don't know. I'm gonna cry. I don't wanna cry.
Aw, Jocelyn.
But I'm gonna miss you guys, and I love you from the bottom of my heart, and best look.
Congratulations, guys, and a lot of joy, and you guys have a beautiful, wonderful future. Yay, I'm so happy for all of you.
Congratulations, Amber, Naji, Hannah, and Lisa
from MFM.
Woo-hoo! Congratulations to all the four graduates, Lisa, Hannah, Naji, and Amber, and I wish you all the best, and you can call me anytime if you have any questions. I also want to say a few things. Naji waking me up 3 a.m. in North Carolina when I was on vacation. I did answer, and if you guys ever told me you are on call, I would really believe that I'm on call. And also Amber, I was on the beach having a drink in Bermuda. She called me. I just had to answer and tell her I'm in Bermuda, so, and you guys are working. So yes, I did get a lot of calls 3, 2 a.m. Like I said, if you told me I'm on call, I would even believe you. So, but please feel free to call me. All of you are really good. Practice what you learn from here and apply it. Four of you are really good. I enjoyed working with you guys, and please feel to call or text me anytime you have any questions in the future. Good luck.
Amber, Naji, Lisa, and Hannah, just wanted to say a very big congratulations to you guys for completing 4 years of OB residency. I'm so proud of everything you guys have done. You're officially the first class of residents that I have not trained with, so this is big for me too. You guys are gonna be awesome. You're rock solid with everything you've done. I've seen you all in action in the best and the worst times, so good luck with everything, and I hope you guys do great.
Congratulations to our graduating residents. The four of you have worked so hard over the past 4 years, and all of you have progressed to become outstanding physicians. best of luck in your future endeavors, and please come back to visit anytime. Good luck.
The graduating chief residents of Good Samaritan Hospital, I wish you well. You'll all do very well. You'll all do fine. And I'll miss you. And good luck. Bye-bye.
Hey guys, if you're getting this video, I've just finished a tour of service at the hospital delivering clinic patients, and we're still in COVID, so your graduation is very limited, which I'm very sorry that you guys have to do it. You deserve more. But it's been great working with you. Congratulations. And things will get better once COVID's over. Again, congratulations. You guys deserve a drink and relax. Good luck on the new future.
Hey guys, congratulations on your graduation. I want to thank you all for the last 4 years. Thanks for all your help, your hard work, and most of all, thanks for your loyalty. Good luck. You guys will do great, I'm sure. I love you all. Have a great day.
Hey guys. I'm hoping that I am the last person who's going to be congratulating you, because I know that they tried to save the best for last. So, obviously, that's got to be me. Maybe. I actually am sitting outside in my backyard, and just wanted to figure that we would end your 4 years the way that we started it. You guys were actually the last class to come to my house for our intern welcome party, so I figured maybe you guys would appreciate the fact that you would end your 4 years here in our backyard. It's truly been an honor and a pleasure to be able to work with you guys. I appreciate the 4 years that you guys have given us. It's truly been amazing to watch you grow and develop, not only professionally, but also personally. You guys have been there for a lot of great milestones in my life, so it's not only the academic part, but it's also the personal part that both Amanda and I appreciate you guys. They said to keep it short and sweet. I don't see a chance that Smapino keeps it under 5 minutes, but can't wait to hear how well he did. Good luck to every single one of you guys. And in closing, not to make this a Hallmark card, but just want you to remember that when you graduate at the end of your 4 years, it's not the end of anything. It's just the beginning of the next phase in your education and the next phase of your lives. And finally, don't focus too much on making a living. Focus more on that end prize and make sure that you live your life. You guys have the knowledge, you have the basis of an absolutely incredible education. Take it, bring it to the next level. I wish you all and your families peace, love, prosperity, and happiness. And I can't end without this. Bye guys.
Naji, Lisa, Amber, and Hannah, I just want to congratulate you on completing your 4 years at Good Sam. You guys all did a great job. You're great people. You're well trained. You really know your stuff. You're going to do well. You're going to kill it out there. I'm very proud of all you guys. I will miss you guys. So please keep in contact with me. Shoot me a text, send me pictures. I'm going to miss you, so don't forget about me, and don't forget your osteopathic heritage. You may want to come to those osteopathic conferences. Maybe we can get together and go out and have a good time. So I wish you guys the best. Love you guys.